Hi, from me, Haria, a South African homesteader. I thought we'd do an update on my potager garden, which is my kitchen garden, or my little food forest, which is right outside my kitchen door. So let's get into it. These are my corn that I planted a while back, and they are doing fantastically. They are so gorgeous. And also we've had quite a bit of rain, so they've really just exploded. And this is my yellow patty pan. Can't remember the name, but it's called lemon sun squash. It's just the lemon sun squash. And this one, I think, is a butternut. This is another squash plant, as well as that. And this. So these ones are all doing well. And then these are my runner beans, and see how nice they are climbing. I think this trellis is too small. But what I'm going to be doing is, as they get bigger, I'm going to wrap them around this so they can climb more. And then I have a green bell pepper here. And then I have some nasturtiums, and they're doing exactly what I wanted them to do. They're trailing over the edge here. And then I have a red bell pepper here. The pepper plants are not doing too well. This is a paprika. And look how big is this. I'm actually growing this for seed. So I am going to be letting this one ripen, and then I'm going to harvest that for seed. These are my cherry bomb peppers, and they're doing quite well, surprisingly well, considering that it's winter. Well, it's almost winter here, and we don't really grow peppers in winter. These are some carrots which somehow got destroyed by one of my animals. This is also carrots here, and they're doing well as well. This here, this is oregano. I have started planting a whole lot of seed. This was also grown from seed, but I only planted one in the garden. And then this is a tomato plant. And surprisingly for the weather, the tomato plant is still surviving, because we've had some pretty cold evenings. And then I have some more nasturtiums, which the idea was to have these trail over the side as well, so I can just... And then we have some cucumbers. I have four cucumber plants in here. It's not the right time to... What is this? This looks like bug damage. But anyway, we have some cucumbers, and that has definitely been pollinated. There's quite a lot of bees in this garden. So this is the cucumber plants. So hopefully we'll get some more cucumbers. And then I have some orange habanero, but something must have eaten this up. I don't know what it is. And some chilies. I took all my pepper plants inside so that they can be out of the cold, and we can just replant them in the spring. And then this is some more nasturtiums, doing exactly what I wanted it to do, trailing down the edge of this bed. I have some red lettuce here. But I think I planted too much nasturtiums, because the nasturtiums is kind of killing this lettuce. There was lettuce there as well, so it's not doing too well there. And then I have a jalapeno here. This is a jalapeno. I'm leaving all these that are planted in ground. I'm in the boxes I'm leaving here. And these are my zinnias. These are fantastic for attracting bees and pollinators. So I'm quite surprised at, I actually cut off quite a few yesterday. Then I also have some, this is actually broccoli, but I have a white butterfly, I think they're called cabbage fly or something, and it keeps coming and laying eggs either underneath the nasturtiums, you can see underneath it, and they've just been munching my brassicas completely out of ground. So this as well, I mean, I've been trying to save this plant in forever, but here you can see there's a ton of them. I must actually come and just take them off with a soapy with some soapy water. And this is this is actually a purple broccoli. And then we have some chrysanthemums here. How beautiful
really
is
this? Really nice.
This is the chrysanthemums. And these are
Look
at
those nice looking flowers. And those yellow ones.
And then we have some more chrysanthemums. Actually, this is some zinnias. And these are zinnias. And then some chrysanthemums.
The yellow ones.
And then this is actually a black mulberry bush that I've grown from seed. About, and there are three plants in here which I will be transplanting. Not quite yet, but when we have permanent space for it, which will not probably
be here. It looks
more
like a strawberry plant.
Then this bead, I think I've just overdone it with an assertion.
It looks like a green pepper and butternut plant.
We've just overdone this with nasturtiums. This was a brassica bead, but because of that white cabbage fly, they have all just not seen the light of day. So what is doing well in here is
Grandma, the pond's getting fuller.
My pepper plant, the pond is so dirty. The pond is so dirty. And in there we have a Cape gooseberry plant. And that one is doing well. The other one I took inside.
Is this a gooseberry?
No, that's mulberry. That's the gooseberry. And then we have another cherry bomb pepper plant here, which these
is this a gooseberry.
See, there's some
grandma, the gooseberry.
And then we have some zinnias. See, there's a little head of zinnia coming out. And here's a head of zinnia.
Little zinnia. Nice one.
This is my lemon tree. I have not been paying attention to this lemon tree at all. So I will
the
be
lemon tree doesn't grow any lemons.
Yeah, we will be
sorting that out.
And then on this side, before I forget, this is my mint, but it's winter here and it's cold and wet and raining, so the mint isn't doing too well.
Can I have one mint?
And this.
Can I have one mint?
This is my. Not dole, this is. I can't think now. But anyway, that's another herb. This is my basil, and I've actually harvested seeds from here, and I'm letting this just go to seed, to save seeds, because I actually have about 50 or 60 little basil plants, which I've started from seed. And then also we have our lemon balm, which also went, I got some seeds from there, and then here some more lemon balm plants coming out. How beautiful is this? It smells delicious. Gorgeous. And in that is marjoram, and then we have some thyme, which is not doing well at all, but I'm just leaving it and hoping that it will set some more leaves. And then this is my passion fruit, which obviously also doesn't have a permanent place yet. Once it has a permanent place, we will put it on a trellis so that it can vine up, and hopefully we'll have beautiful passion fruit in summer. And then this is another pepper plant. This, I actually heavily trimmed this for winter now, so that in spring we'll have lots more growth. This one I completely trimmed down. I think it was more than a third. So this hopefully will also, I only just did this I think 2 days ago, so this will also. We have some beautiful marigolds, and then we have a little lettuce that just popped up here, and then we have zinnias, more zinnias. The zinnias are so cool because they attract so many pollinators, and then I have lots and lots of nasturtiums. I absolutely love the nasturtiums and the way it just makes it look all wild. And so in here, this bed actually gets a lot of rain because, so here we have some marigolds, we have some nasturtiums, we have a little pepper plant that's not doing too well, but what I did do is I planted some radish in here, and they are looking good. Oh my word, this is looking so good. I haven't been out here. Here's some weeds. So we have some beautiful radish growing here. More marigolds, more zinnias, and then another pepper plant up here. This is a peach tree, which obviously will be losing all these leaves now in winter. We had about 3 peaches now the past season from them. So, oh, I didn't show you my eggplant. This is my eggplant, and I actually have 2 eggplants on here. I have had a huge success with eggplants, especially the eggplants on the side, in the side garden. And these eggplants here. So, I've had huge success with eggplant. I think these are petunias that just popped into this plant. This was actually a rosemary plant which completely died. But then I saw these and it looks like petunias, so I'm just leaving that. Okay, so then let's head over to this bed. This, again, doing exactly what the intention was, which was for this to just trail over the edge. We have a pepper plant there. But the most important thing in this bed for me is my tomatoes. OMG, I am growing these tomatoes for seed because I don't have that many, but this is just putting on tomatoes. These are the purple tomatoes, which I have never tasted, never eaten. It's a Mexican, it grows in Mexico, it just grows all over, and they use it for salsas and salsas. It's quite tart, it's sour. So, but look at all these flowers. Apparently you can get about 200 from one plant, and these are 2 plants. You cannot plant this just one plant because they cross-pollinate, so you have to plant 2 plants. But I am so super impressed because they grow inside of this husk, and then once the husk starts, you can feel that when it's soft like that, they're not ready. You can actually feel as they fall out the husk. I have never grown them before, I've never eaten it. I'm excited. I'm definitely going to be making some salsa with this. And I have this beautiful zinnias growing in between here. This garden is just, this is a classroom garden, a sort of a garden that this is a garden that I just planted while I'm in a sort of a waiting stage for things, and which I will tell you about much later in the year. And then we can talk more in depth about that and the process that I find myself in. This is actually one of my grandchildren's pepper plants, which I've given all of them seeds. And this is Abdrahman's, and this is Kothar's little garden. But I see, no, this is Mudathir's. And then I see Kothar's is not doing too well. So I'm going to be giving you some new pepper plants. Grandma had got some, but not now, because it's winter. And this, friends, is what is happening in my little homestead at the moment. It is just too beautiful for words. So when you look at it from a glance, it doesn't look like there's much happening in here, but the amount of food that is growing in here is actually quite a lot. I'm excited for these. I'm actually quite excited for these because with the corn, like I haven't actually mentioned that these are two types. It is this one here is this is the bloody butcher corn. So I've kept most of my seeds. I've just tried out four, and hopefully I'll be able to harvest some seeds from here so that I can increase my seed. It is an heirloom, so it's open pollinated, so which means you can harvest the seeds and you will it will grow true to type. And then the others are sweet bantam corn. Yeah, that's what it is, sweet bantam corn. And then we have, obviously we have these. And then I have, I'm going to be telling you what's happening here. This is a fiberglass roof sheet, so it lets in lots of light. And because it's winter here, I do not want to attempt to put my tomato plants outside because they don't do too well. So I have a moneymaker tomato plant. This I brought in all my pepper plants yesterday because they were not doing well at all. So those are the pepper plants. I'm hoping to overwinter them here. And then this is a smoky cherry tomato. This is a black crimp tomato. This is, I think it's a jalapeno. This, you can just look at the pepper and see that it's a cherry bomb pepper. This is the yellow cherry. I don't know what kind. I got the seeds from my son-in-law, so I don't know what kind of cherry, but it's so sweet. I don't think it's sun gold, but it's definitely a very nice tomato. And then this is the banana leeks, which, in fact, most of the tomatoes that I'm growing here is for more seeds because I want to order different types of seeds in the new season. These are the Cherokee purple. That's a Cherokee purple and clear pink. I know that the season that this is growing in is not right. These are the giant Belgium, but it's struggling a bit. I need to take it out of this and put in a bigger pot. Then what I've also got here is all of these. These are the basil plants, which I've just sown them all in a sort of flat tray. And then when they were quite, when they were big enough, I transplanted them into these pots. So these are the sweet basil, all grown from seed, but there's a lot. I have many of these. So the idea is for these to individually be planted in pots, or maybe two in a pot, and then have them once they are bigger. Then these are black mustard, and I'm so excited. This also I sowed in a pot. It actually, this is such a beautiful microgreen. I actually tasted it and it is so beautiful. Apparently, the longer it grows, the spicier it becomes. So these are the black mustard, and I have plenty of these. I also transplanted them about a few days ago, and I see that they're doing quite well after being transplanted. Then we have this little apple tree, which I also started from seed. Now, I know that apples do not grow true to type. This is an apple from seeds from store-bought apples. But because they usually become, they don't grow true to type. So they will be like crab apples. But the blossoms, if they, you don't know, they might be the most fabulously sweet apple, or they might just be a crab apple, small and tiny, or that is inedible. But the blossoms that these eventually do set is so beautiful. It does take years and years to grow the tree from seed, but I have time. This is the gooseberry I was speaking about that was top part was annihilated by some critter. I don't know which one, but something happened there. This was a fig tree that I planted from seed, but I was saying this leaf doesn't look like figs. I don't know if one of the other seeds that I had maybe fell into the cell. So I don't know if any of you can recognize this. I can probably do a, I have an app, Leaf Snap, which I can check if it is actually a fig leaf. I know the fig leaf looked like a hand, and this doesn't, so I'm not sure what that is. These are two pineapples which we rooted inside, and they have now been planted in here. So that will one day go into its permanent ground home as well, or I'll just leave it in there for a while. And in this is some more of the pepper plants which I brought in yesterday. Now, this is Strelitzia nicolai, and it's got the most beautiful orange and black seed. And they, I actually let them sprout under the lights. Actually, not under the lights, but inside, below the lights, where it's quite dark. In a closed Tupperware container, and they sprouted, and I planted them. So I have plenty of these. Many of them are outside, so I brought these in case it gets killed outside. I see these one coming up. Oh my word, there's one coming up as well. So, and this is what it looks like. I'm actually going to show you what the tree, the big tree, looks like. We actually got these seeds from this tree. So this is what the Strelitzia nicolai looks like. Some people call it a banana, a wild banana tree, but the scientific name is actually Strelitzia nicolai. And I'm growing plenty of those because I'm hoping to have enough of those for a future garden. Then I also have, I don't know if you remember the a previous video that I posted about the date seeds that I planted, and these are the date seeds. Look at this. I have a little date palm. I actually started these under also in a container inside. I actually have a video which I will link in my description below on how I started these palms, the date palms. And I know I have to wait about 5 to 8 years, but it's so worth the wait because the trees in itself are so beautiful. And I'm hoping to have plenty of space one day to plant most of these. I also have some that have not sprouted yet. So as they sprout, I just put them here. See these little teeny mini sprouts there. So that's the date palms. Then I have some, let's take this down. I have some blonde peri head lettuce which I've started. I actually planted out, I think, 3 of these, but they were too small, so they died. But I'm waiting for these to get a little bit bigger. They don't look, they look a bit flimsy at the moment, but I will get these. I will get these to grow strong. Yeah, so these are the blonde peri lettuce, which I will plant in one of those beds. And that's another cherry bomb pepper. And then I'm growing my own potatoes, sweet potato slips. I actually have some inside my kitchen window over there, which look at the roots over there. And that too is not for here. Yeah, well, I'm hoping to one day have a huge sweet potato bed. And these are more slips. So those I've also grown from these sweet potatoes. And then these were, there was nothing left on there, and then I just decided to pack it in some seed starting mix, and I keep it moist, and there we have some more sweet potato slips growing. So I do have a tomato plant outside, which I covered when the nights were really cold and frosty, although we didn't get anywhere close to 0 degrees Celsius. But I see, I don't know if you can see, I see some little, and I think these are flowers that is going to be setting, it's starting to set fruit. I am so super excited. So this is my tomato plant, which I took a chance on leaving outside. So if you enjoyed today's garden tour, please give it a like. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see some more of these videos and follow us on our journey. And also leave a comment if you have any comments on what I'm growing, if you have something that you may add that might help me in future. And yeah, so don't forget to share it amongst all your friends, and we hope to chat to you next time. From me, Heria, at South African Homesteader, may Allah bless you.